How is it that 3 albums in a row can be so absolutely unremarkable? I think the answer is abundance. Weezer needs to stop making so many albums. And then they made another. And another. And now, there's another on the way. I'm not sure how Van Weezer is going to sound when it comes out. So far, it seems relatively promising. But please, 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 take a break. You might remember that at the end, I mentioned a new album Weezer was working on called Van Weezer that hadn't yet come out. Well, Weezer just dropped a new album. No, it isn't Van Weezer. It's a different album. A new album. It happened, at long last. And no, not a different album this time. This time, it's really here. Van Weezer is really here. So let's talk about Van Weezer. This is the album that was concocted by the boys with the intention of blasting the faces off of stadium audiences during the Hella Mega Tour. That's the concept. But what is Van Weezer, really? To me, Van Weezer is a 10-track rock odyssey that makes you miss your Walkman and your tubular Bermuda shorts, despite the fact that you were born in 1998. I think it's been told that the sound on this record was achieved by taking every single Kiss record, putting it through an AI computer that then paired it with every single Weezer record, taught itself how to play instruments, and then implanted itself directly into River's brain. But what makes up this album? The album starts with Hero, which has sort of a Perfect Situation vibe. It's got a really catchy chorus, and I think it's a really good way to start the record. The lyrics are a little corny and like nerdy, but I mean, come on, this is Weezer after all. Secondary is All the Good Ones. This song has that sort of Rivers talk singing that you all know I love. But, you know, it also has a sound similar to the Weezer Forbidden era, you know, Beverly Hills. And the guitar leads and synth, what sounds like synth leads during the chorus, sounds super nice, so I don't hate it. Next, we have The End of the Game. This song captures the spirit of the album, I think, very well, where it has sort of the 80s glam intentions, but with the Weezer sensibilities, you know, the lyricism and the sort of crunchy guitars. This song's been out forever, so I mean, there's not too much new to say about it. If you're sort of in tune with the Weezer universe, you've probably heard the song plenty by now. I Need Some of That is the next track, with a ginormous intro that leads into sort of like a more pulled back, sort of like mid crunchy, almost clean tone kind of verse, you know, verse chorus, quiet verse, loud chorus kind of thing. The lyrics call back to that sort of 80s vibe, which, you know, obviously is the whole theme of the album. And musically, it kind of sounds like something you'd hear on the Green album. Next track is The Beginning of the End, which starts with this sort of garagey, sort of mid-distorted guitar tone, similar to guitar tones you might hear on like certain songs on the Red album. This song kind of picks up the album from like some of the more mid-tempo songs. This one's more rockin' and quick, has a lot of really soaring guitar solo and sweeping guitar solo work. Very cool. Next up, sneaking its way in, is Blue Dream. This song is built on the riff of Crazy Train by Ozzy Osbourne, and it's not like especially enjoyable. It wasn't for me. I feel there's like too much going on. There's a lot of layering of just different things and really not enough reward. And the solo, I guess, is cool in it, but it feels like filler. While Blue Dream is sneaky, One More Hit screams in your face. This is basically Weezer goes Red Fang, as Red Fang as Weezer could go. The solo is very pretty. It's got that sort of like doomy, that sounds weird to say for a Weezer song, but it kind of has like light doomy qualities. And it randomly just becomes like a Slayer song for one point, just for like a second. Yeah, it's a cool song. Sheila Can Do It is track number 8. Now, when I heard the name of this song, I thought, hey, that kind of sounds like the name of a Ramones song. And when I listen to it, that's kind of the vibe you get. It's like, this sounds like a song that the Ramones would write in 2021 if they weren't all dead. And if they were Weezer. Track number 9 is She Needs Me. And I know that the sort of overall feeling of this album is supposed to be like 80s rock, you know? But this song almost has like sensibilities of like the Beatles music in the early 60s mixed with like that 80s glam sound and also like Weezer. I don't know. It's a really interesting mix, but it's a cool song. Last but certainly least, if we're talking decibels, is Precious Metal Girl. This was sort of an interesting way to end this album. You know, it's a very stadium-friendly album, and then they end it with an acoustic song. It's sort of like ending Pinkerton with Butterfly, but for this album, I don't feel like it makes that much sense. It feels like something that Rivers would play solo and not like something Weezer would play in a stadium, you know? It feels like it belongs more on like the next Alone release. I don't know. So that is the life and limb of Van Weezer. I think that this album is very effective in doing exactly what it set out to do. It's a fun, rockin' album. It has moments that have you wanting to dance, want to get up and move, want to sing along, nod your head, and I think that's what they wanted to make, so in that sense, yes, it's very effective. Does this album break any boundaries? Not really, but this isn't fucking Frank Zappa or Captain Beefheart. It's Weezer. You know, and even when Weezer breaks boundaries in their own sound, it still has that sort of Weezer vibe. You probably realize that as I was going through the tracks, I would often say like, oh, this has sounds that are sort of reminiscent of this era of Weezer, this album, whatever. And I think that that's something that they did well in this album is they sort of called back to certain sounds of the Weezer yesteryear, but they brought new life into it with this sort of new concept and this like new production. And the production is good. The production is like, it sounds big. It doesn't sound too flat. River's voice sounds better than it has in a long time. There's really a lot of power in his voice. It doesn't sound like he's kind of just moseying through it. So that is very cool. I'd say that if this is the next album that Weezer writes with the intention of touring and playing, then they made a lot of the right choices in the way they wrote it. Now I just hope that they take a break before forcing another album through the machine and directly into our over-encumbered ears. OK Human was good. Van Weezer was good. Let them marinate. Let them sit and just become classics in their own right in a sea of other music. In my opinion, this album is a 7.8. An 8, maybe, if I'm liquored up. It's not really innovative, but it's fun. And is that not the whole point of this album? To have something fun for the masses to enjoy when those loud, giant, disgusting, germ-filled stadium concerts are once again allowed? From what I understand, that was the goal. And they achieved it. Should you listen to Van Weezer? Yeah, why not? You might love it more than I do, you might hate it more than I do. But you won't know unless you listen, so you might as well give it a listen. I'm sure that there are a lot of people who will find a lot to love about this album and might even see it as a 10. Who knows? But you won't know unless you give it a listen. And it's out now, so why not give it a listen? Thanks for tuning in once again and listening to me ramble about Weezer. I like making these videos because I like Weezer and I like talking about Weezer. If you like the video, why not give it a like? And hey, maybe even subscribe. Will I make more videos in the future? Yeah, maybe, possibly. But if I do, you'll be the first to know. So go out there, get yourself a copy of Van Weezer, or just go on Spotify or YouTube or wherever you listen to music for free, and just listen to the album. And if you like it, then you can purchase it. Who knows? But I think that it's worth giving it a listen if you like Weezer. So anyway, I'm glad you came by, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.